Okay, so now we're going to look at sort of a systematic procedure for determining what the shape function should be, all right? So if we assume we have a domain, a continuous domain, all right, let's discretize it into two elements. And we're going to use a coordinate system. So we'll number the elements, say 0. I'm sorry, we're going to number the nodes, 0, 1, 2. And we'll number the elements, omega E1, omega E2. Right? So if we have a coordinate system that starts at node 0, then the x location we'll call xa. So the x location of node 1 we'll call xa, and the x location of node 2 we'll call xb. All right? And so we're going to look at node 1 in isolation. I'm sorry, we're gonna look at node 2 in isolation. Not that it really matters, but just to be consistent with my... So we have, this is node 1, node 2, this is element 2. Right, we're going to assume a polynomial interpolant C1 plus C2x. All right. And then we'll evaluate this function at the nodes. So we have u of h at xa is equal to C1 plus C2xa. And we're going to define that as the displacement of element 1. I'm sorry, the displacement of node 1. And then let's evaluate it at xb. We have c1 plus c2xb. And we're going to define that as the displacement of node 2. So if we write this thing as a matrix equation, and we have this, so the solution to this, or you know, if we write this as u a c, well, what's the solution to that guy for c? What's the solution to a linear matrix equation? A inverse U. Right, so C is A inverse U. So in this case, C is equal to U2 XA minus U1 XB all over xa minus xb u2. So in other words, C1 is equal to U2 XA minus U1 So if we substitute that back into our approximate solution, so now we have it in the form we just may not see it, and that is U1E phi 1 plus U2E phi 2. So what we need to do is just factor this equation, pulling out the U's. And if we do that, then you have U1 is equal to X minus XB XA XB plus U2 XA minus X, XA minus XB. All right, so that's just rearranging this equation. And so this then is phi 1, this is phi 2. So those are our shape functions. Now, if we assume a coordinate system that's local to the element, so basically what I mean is that each element has its own little coordinate system. So this is that same element, where XB minus XA is equal to L. That's the length of the element. Then you have UH is equal to U1 X minus L over L plus U2 X over L, or U1 1 minus X over L. So sometimes you'll see that U of H is equal to Vj, Uj, where you have 1 minus X over L, X over L, U1, U2. And when it's written like this, this is called Vj, this is the shape function matrix.